Good morning, students. Hope you are all good after this Niwar cyclone. So please take care of that. Fine. Now let us have the revision for unit test 2. Here we go. Let us start with the choose the correct answer. Before that, I want to say you the let you know about the question pattern. You will be having 10 2 marks. I'm 5 2 marks, totally 10 marks for biology. Okay, so we shall start with this choose the correct answer. A plant that has seeds but no flowers and fruits, what is the answer here? Is it bryophytes, gymnosperms, mosses or pteridophytes? No flowers, no fruits. Okay, no flower kedaiyad fruit kedaiyad adu enadhu ipo gymnosperms. Okay, so the answer is gymnosperms. Plants having vascular tissue without seeds, seed illama vascular tissues irukku adu enna type of enna kingdom la varum, plant kingdom la enna subdivision varum, it is from pteridophytes. Okay, pteridophytes, that's the answer here. I already told you how to pronounce pteridophytes. Here p is silent and you have to start the pronunciation with T. So pteridophytes. Okay, the next question is vascular tissue for conduction of water and other substances is present in which of the following here? We have gymnosperms, pteridophytes, both of these, none of these. Which one will be the right answer here? Vascular tissue for conduction of water. Water is the conduct pannum and other substances. இதுல இருக்கும் both gymnosperms as well as in pteridophytes. So the answer is both of these. Okay, next we have lint plants. Archaebacteria belongs to kingdom dash. So which kingdom does it belong? Kingdom Monera. Okay, methanogens are seen in dash area, in marshy area. What is marshy? Marshy nana sonna serum sagadhima irukadhu, adhu sadhuppu nilam solradhu. Okay, there we can see large number of methanogens. Okay, Clostridium is an example for dash. Edukana example idu eubacteria. We have studied, no, hope you remember the classes. Okay, answer the following questions. Classify fungi based on spore formation. So what are the classifications we have studied in fungi? It's zygomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. How to pronounce that? Zygomycetes. Zygomycetes. Okay, similarly we have to pronounce this as ascomycetes, and here basidiomycetes. Repeat, basic D-I-O-D-O-M-Y-M-Y-C-E-C-T-E-S-T-S, basidiomycetes. And here we have deuteromycetes, D-E-U-D-U-T-E-T-R-O-R-O-M-Y-M-Y-C-E-C-T-E-S-T-S, deuteromycetes. So what are the classifications for fungi based on the spore formation? We have studied four classifications here. What are they? Zygomycetes, ascomycetes, basidiomycetes and deuteromycetes. Okay, and the next is define hyphae. What is hyphae? It's a short fragment like thing. Hope you remember what I told in class. Fungi consist of a long thread like structures known as hyphae. Okay, thread like, finger like structure or thread like structure bathroom. Hope you all remember that. Different mycelium, these hyphae together form a mesh like structure called mycelium. So those hyphae we had seen, no, adula mesh like structure irukum, adhaadu enadhu mesh mariyana oru structure irukum, that is called mycelium. Already we had seen those things in class, we are now just revising it. Okay, if you wish to see, please take down those notes and see. Okay, and then come to this question and answer session. Okay, what are the types of classification of organisms? We have three types, sir. One is artificial classification, second one is natural classification, Third one is phylogenetic classification. What are the classification we have studied here? Artificial, natural, and phylogenetic classification. Okay. Next question is, define artificial classification. What is artificial classification? The system of classification which is based on one or few random criteria such as habitat or one or more major habitat of organisms. That is called artificial classification. யாவர்க்க எல்லாருக்கும் ஹேபிடேட்டோ இல்லை ஆர்கனிசமோட ஏதாவது ஒரு ஹேபிட்டையோ வச்சு கிளாஸிஃபை பண்ணுறது தான் வந்துட்டு ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் கிளாஸிஃபிகேஷன். What are the disadvantages of artificial classification? Give example. What are the disadvantages we have studied? One or few random criteria is taken. Not, it does not reflect on natural relationship and it has different types grouped together. For example, flying animals like insects, example butterfly, birds, example parrot and bats. These three are combined. Okay, but the same types are separated here. For example, mammals, flying mammals, bat is a flying mammal here, and where is the aquatic mammal, and rat is the land mammal. So these three are combined as mammals, but one is flying, one is in ocean, another one is in terrestrial, means land. Okay, so idellam combine panitaanga. So idellame disadvantages of artificial classification. Okay, next is define phylogenetic classification. What do you mean by phylogenetic genetic classification? It means evolutionary relationship based பண்ணி இருக்குது. It means what? ஏற்கனவே evolve ஆன organisms நம்ம classify பண்ணி வைக்கிறோம். Okay, so the system of classification which is based on the evolutionary relationship is called phylogenetic classification. Okay, fine. Next is write down the kingdom system of classification by R. H. Whitaker. So how R.H. Whitaker classified the living things? He had classified into five groups. One is animals, plants, fungi, protista and monera. Totally what? How many? Five. What are they? Animals, plants, fungi, protista and monera. Okay. Give example for eugenoids and dinoflagellates. He had studied these things, no? Eugenoids and dinoflagellates. What are the examples? Eugenoids ku Eugenia, Trichomonas, dinoflagellates ku Noctiluca. Okay, how to pronounce this? Trichomonas, T R A, tra, C H E, K L O, lo, M O, mo, N A S, nas. Trichomonas. Okay, Trichomonas. Okay, so what are the examples for eugenoids here? Euglena and Trichomonas. Next, for dinoflagellates, Noctiluca. Okay, N-O-C, Noc, T-I-T-L-U-C-A-C-A. Okay, Noctiluca. So what are the types of bacteria we have studied? Based on the shape of bacteria, we have spherical type, rod shape, comma shape and spiral shape. What are they? Spherical, rod, comma and spiral shape. Okay, what is the next question here? Classify kingdom protista and explain any four. So what are the classification of kingdom protista here? Chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime mold and protozoans. What are they? Chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime mold, protozoans. Okay, hope you can pronounce these words easily. Okay, what are chrysophytes we have studied? Chrysophytes are characterized by the presence of hard siliceous cell wall. It means what? Siliceous na silica irukirathu, silica component. Okay, so example is diatoms and golden algae. Do you remember the images what I had shown in the class? Okay, diatoms and golden algae. If you don't remember, please go through that and then get back to the revision video here. Okay, diatoms or photosynthetic organisms. Okay, these dinoflagellates are photosynthetic and found in various different colors according to the pigment present in them. So it will reflect the pigment what is present there. So some marine organisms show bioluminescence and it emits the light. Hope you remember this too. In the last class I had shown the images of these dinoflagellates. Okay, example is Noctiluca. Next is Eublenoids. Eublenoids are the link between the plants and animals. Animal marine construct பண்ணலாம், plant marine construct பண்ணிக்கலாம். Okay, so they act as a heterotroph and feed on small organisms. Okay, the outer body covering is a protein rich layer known as pellicle. Okay, example is Euglena and Trichilomonas. Okay, next is slime molds. Slime molds are saprophytic organisms. They feed on the dead and decaying matter. Okay, so these are tiny organisms that have many nuclei. They are classified into acellular and cellular slime molds. Slime molds are characterized by the presence of aggregates called plasmodium, and even they are visible to the naked eye. Example is Physarum. Okay, so what and all we have studied under protista, under kingdom protista we have five. One is chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, euglenoids, slime mold and protozoans. Okay, fine. The next question is classify protozoa and explain. So protozoans are classified as what? Amoeboid, flagellated, ciliated and sporozoans. What are they? Repeat. Amoeboid, flagellated, ciliated and sporozoans. So amoeboid protozoans. Amoeboid niya solrom adu amoeba mariyana characters explain pannu. Okay, so it is found in water bodies either fresh or saline. So saline water liyum irukalam adu illati where in fresh water la irukalam. Okay, so they have pseudopodia which help to change the shape and in capturing and engulfing the food. How the amoeba engulf the food? Like it has pseudopodial feet. Okay, pseudo means false, podia means feet. Okay, false feet. So and the poiyana kaal mari irukiradha adu vachi da adu engulf panikum. Class la na solliruken, hope you all remember that. So example for amoeboid protozoans are what? Example is amoeba. Okay, flagellated protozoans. Flagellated protozoans have flagella. They can be free living as well as parasitic. Okay, example for this is Euglena. Okay, then ciliated protozoans, they have cilia which help in locomotion and nutrition. Cilia na enna sonnalana seep mari, seep thala varumle seep adha pallu palla irukku illaya andha mariyana structure da idhula, but it will be flexible or brush pandrala tooth brush adhula eppadi irukum kuchi kucha irukku illaya fibers mari. So those are called cilia like structure. Adha cilia like structure adha vachi da adhu locomote panum. Locomote na enadhu? Moving, movement. Okay, locomotion means what? Locating its place from one place to another. Okay, motion. Loco na location, motion na the movement. Okay, that is called locomotion. So using the cilia, it will, these protozoans will move. Okay, and using the cilia only it will feed on food. So nutrition ko idu useful ah irukum. The cilia protozoans, cilia vachi da nutrition adha saapadu food ku adu use pannikum cilia. Okay, they are always aquatic. So idellame thannila da irukum aquatic. Okay, example is paramecium. Hope you remember the structure of paramecium. Outer, in the outer surface, outer layer, it will have cilia. Okay, fine. Next is sporozoans. What are sporozoans? Malarial parasite, plasmodium, idellame sporozoans la varum. Their life cycle has a spore like stage. Okay, so mention any four phylum kingdom Animalia. In kingdom Animalia with example. So there are almost 10 phylum in kingdom Animalia. Here the, in this question they had asked only 4. So any 4 you can write. So I had given these 4. You may write if you wish. other phylum also, but any four you have to write here. Okay, I hope you are clear about this question. Porifera, example is Spongilla cycon. Porifera, P-O-P-O-R-I-D-F-E-F-A-R-A-R-A. Okay, Porifera. Example is kenna Spongilla, S-P-O, spawn, G-I-L, jill, L-A, la, Spongilla. Okay, cycon, S-Y-C-O-N, con. This is how you have to pronounce. Next is seal and preta. நான் எப்போதும் சொல்லியிருக்கேன் சிஓஇ வந்தாலே அது சீன்னு ப்ரொனவுன்ஸ் பண்ணணும். ஓகே, சிஓஇ இஸ் சி, எல்இஎன் லென், டிஇ டே, ஆர்ஏ ரா, டிஏ டா, சீல் அண்ட் ட்ரேட்டா. ஓகே, ஃபார் திஸ் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் ஹைட்ரா ஆரிலியா, ஆரிலியா. ஓகே, அண்ட் ஃபார் ஆர்த்ரோபோடா தி எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் பட்டர்ஃப்ளை, மஸ்கிட்டோஸ் and mosquitoes. Mollusca, example is octopus and snails. Okay, so these are the four phylums I had given. If you wish to give some other phylum in kingdom Animalia, you may. Okay, fine. The next question is, write short note on Basidiomycetes. So Basidiomycetes, edha nam padichom Basidiomycetes, that video first picture enna kuduthirukka, mushroom, nyabar ka? Yes, hope you remember. Agaricus comes here. If you don't remember that, please go through that video, then come back to this revision video so that you can easily study this. Okay, mushrooms are the most commonly found as Basidiomycetes and mostly live as parasites here. Okay, so they are they reproduce sexually, so sexual reproduction occurs in basidiospores. Asexual reproduction occurs by conidia, budding or fragmentation. Asexual reproduce பண்ணும், அது எதை வச்சு பண்ணா conidia, அப்புறம் budding, buds மாதிரி ரைஸ் ஆகும், ஆர் ஃப்ராக்மெண்டேஷன். வாட் யூ மீன் பை ஃப்ராக்மெண்டேஷன், துண்டு துண்டா விழருது, கட் அதுவே தன்னை கட் பண்ணி கட் பண்ணி செல்ஸோட தனித்தனியாக பிரிச்சுக்கும் அது. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவ் இட் வில் ரீப்ரொடியூஸ். ஸோ எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஸ் அகாடிகஸ் ஹியர். நெக்ஸ்ட் இஸ் What are the five plant kingdoms and write down the criteria for classification. What are the five kingdoms we have studied? Plant kingdom is divided into five things. One is Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperms and Angiosperms. What are they? I repeat. Thallophyta, Bryophyta, Pteridophyta, Gymnosperms and Angiosperms. Totally five we have. Okay, so classification is based, we had classified these plant kingdom based on the following criteria: plant body, vascular system and seed formation. Plant oda body structure eppadi irukkanum, appo adukulla vascular system eppadi arrange a irukkanum, then seed formation, seed iruka chinna vadiya iruka illa kotta mari perusa iruka appadina paatha adu classify pannirukku. Okay, next question is, what is the different phylum of the animal kingdom? What are the phylum we had studied? Porifera, seal and preta, platyhelminthes, nematoda, annelida, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata. It is easier remember pannadukku na sollirundhen ungalku chem ma. Okay, so நிமோனிக்ஸ் நான் இருக்குமே சொல்லியிருந்தேன், ப்ளீஸ் ரெஃபர் தட் அண்ட் ரீட். ஓகே, ஃபைன். ஸோ தட்ஸ் தி ரிவிஷன் பார்ட் ஹியர். ஸோ ப்ளீஸ் பி தர வித் ஆல் க்வெஷ்சன்ஸ். டிஸ்அட்வான்டேஜஸ் ஆஃப் ஆர்டிஃபிஷியல் கிளாசிஃபிகேஷன், கிங்டம் புரோட்டிஸ்டா, தென் ஃபைலம் இன் ஆனிமல் கிங்டம், ஓகே, and the plant kingdom classification, everything you have to be very clear for the test. So prepare well for the test. All the best. Thank you.